Hey, what's going on, everybody? This is Mike at HiFiInsider.com. Today, I have a brand new product to share with you. This product, when I first saw the press release, I was very, very intrigued by it because it brings you some features that no other products today are offering. So I thought I'd reach out to my friends at RHA and send out a review unit for me to check out. And here it is. So this is the wireless flight adapter, they call it. But there's certainly more than you can do than use it on an airplane. And we'll take a look at that and I'll give you my experiences with it so far. So as you can see on the packaging, very clean, very nice packaging. It's got a little banged up from UPS because they actually lost the shipment for a few days. And then it finally arrived. So some details about the product: stream audio from in-flight entertainment systems. So, and then you got the RHA authenticity sticker. USB-C charging cable is included. AptX streaming technology. And then just some regulation stuff. So show you guys what's inside. So here's the airline adapter. Pop this guy out for you. And then you get a USB-C to USB-A cable, a short one, so it's very nice. And then you have the owner's manual. And RHA has a unconditional 3-year warranty on their stuff, so you know that you're going to be protected by their products and support, so we don't need to look at that. So this is the owner's manual. It comes in a variety of languages. Now, one thing that I like about this owner's manual is that it's color. It's not just black and white. So you can see it, there's a blue dot there. So, for example, when you're looking at the light indicator, you can actually tell, you know, what it relates to by the colors on this manual. Rather than just, you know, looking at the black and white. So the little lines around the color dot means that it's flashing. So just some information about that. And then pairing mode, how to pair this thing. So we'll talk about that. But when you get this product, you should definitely look at the manual so you can learn how to use it. So let's look at the product itself first. You can certainly remove this FCC and CE logo sticker here. Haven't had a chance to do that yet. Now there is a light here, which I will turn it on. This is the only button that it has. So there's the light. And on the back, there are little dots to tell you which is the primary and which is the secondary jack. So when you're using this device with something that only has one 3.5 millimeter stereo jack, you should use the primary connector and rather than the secondary. So some airlines, and you know, mostly international, I think, have an airline media entertainment system that requires two jacks to get the stereo sound. So you'll need to use both of the jacks, So what's good about this little device is that it turns that output into a wireless device. So you can pair your wireless headphones or earphones, and for me, in the case I have the AirPods, to this RHA device, and you can listen to the media without being tied down by the cord. Certainly very, very useful. I travel with my AirPods and sometimes with another set of wireless headphones. So this certainly allows me to use my wireless headphones a lot more in more ways, especially when I want to watch something on an in-flight entertainment system. Sometimes, you know, those entertainment systems have newer movies that you can't get on Netflix yet. So, you know, as bad as it is to use those things, this certainly would improve that experience, and you're not tied down by the cord. Now, another thing that you can use it with is on the back of your TV. If you want to use earphones with your TV and your TV does not have Bluetooth, so you can plug this on the back of your TV and basically have earphones connected to it, which is really good for someone who is hard of hearing, or if you watch a lot of movies or shows in late night and you don't want to disturb the family. You can also use this in your car. Most cars have a audio jack, and you can plug it into your car and have wireless headphones in your car. So there's a lot of ways that you can use this. Anything with a 3.5 millimeter stereo output, and you can basically turn that device into a wireless media player. Now, what's really cool about this is that you can connect it to two different pairs of headphones simultaneously. You can use them simultaneously, and they work really, really well. If your headphones don't have aptX, it defaults to SBC. It does not have AAC, so in the case of the AirPods, it goes to SBC. Now, to be truthful, I've compared LDAC, aptX, SBC, AAC. The sound quality between those protocols is really, really small. If you have anything other than, if you have any environmental noise or if you're distracted by something else, you're really not going to hear much of a difference. So I think that SBC is certainly a more universal protocol and is more reliable connection as well. Now, I was able to pair the two AirPods. I used the two AirPods for the test because I wanted to see what the latency is. Between the AirPods to the RHA, when using one, latency is undetectable. There's really, I can't tell, you know, the lip sync, any lip sync issues. Now, when you're using two earphones together, between the two headphones, there is a slight bit of latency.
And some security researchers spent some time with this. They notified Zoom. Zoom did not act quickly enough to deal with this.
Between the two. So, you know, the only way you can actually tell is where one buds on one side and the other side, a different set of buds. And then you would be able to tell there's a slight latency delay. But that's certainly not the normal use. The downside about this is that when you turn it off, it loses the connection to the second pairing. Now, you can pair multiple headphones to it, but when it's paired for simultaneous use, it does not remember the second pair. So to work around that, you can actually plug this into a power source and keep it turned on all the time. So a lot of TVs now have a USB port. So basically you can connect this to power and then connect this to the back of the audio output on your TV. And then you have two sets of earphones or wireless headphones paired all the time without any loss in pairing, and it will just work each and every time you put it on. And I have not had any issues with the AirPods and with my other earphones, and even with the, of course, with the RHA headphones, in terms of dropouts, no dropouts at all. So I am very pleased and impressed by this little product, and it's so small that you can easily travel with. It's smaller than the AirPods case. It has USB-C. This is something that's going to be in my bag forever, and I might even pick up another pair just so that I have it in my second bag in case I use a different bag. Very unique product, amazing sound quality, easy to use, just everything is done right. Oh, by the way, this uses Bluetooth 5.0, so the range is very, very strong. I can't say, you know, enough good things about this product. This is amazing. And I urge you guys to pick it up if you like to use wireless headphones. Now, if you want to support the channel and buy this product, I'll put it the Amazon link in the description for you guys. I don't ask you guys to support me on Patreon or have any sponsored content on this channel. So the only way to support this channel, if you want to, is by watching the videos, of course, and also using my Amazon link below. Now, my Amazon store has a lot of different things, so take a look at that. Maybe you'll find something that you'll find interesting. It's not all tech, so the things that I like, I use, that I bought, I put it on my store. So, all right, everyone, thanks for watching my videos, and I'll see you guys again in my next one. Bye-bye.